that we now know will not be present in this concept.
Most
garbage men gone, right?
Yes. All repetition. All
male men would laugh at you, and now all this is very believable. Uh-huh. All right, onward.
You've got to be prepared to face the future.
Looks like a train station.
After the automobile is phased out, which we hope to do very rapidly, we hope to build a new transportation system and also phase out all forms of aircraft except surveillance. Aircraft, helicopters. We think aircraft are no longer necessary. In fact, the skies are so jammed and landing is so difficult and the speeds and the shockwave are no longer worth working on. I know the people in the aircraft business do not understand this, nor do they feel this, because they feel that all institutions tend to perpetuate themselves.
Society, there are no mayors of cities.
There are no mayors, there are no politicians, and you don't have to fill out any forms to go to the art center or music center, and you go to a university whether you can afford it or not. You don't have to use any of the system today. Let me briefly say this. You have a bumper in front of your car, behind your car. But your society, your car's hit on the side also. You have safety belts and harnesses in your car. But that assumes that you're going to be hit by the rear or in front. If you're hit on the side, you go right through the side of the windshield. What good are these approaches? They are designed by men that are cerebral insufficients. You've got to design a society with a bumper all around the car, phase out human drivers, put electronic guidance systems in cars, or eliminate the automobile and design a holistic transportation system. We must put our mind to this as we do to put a man on the moon. We must put our mind to the social problem. We wish to get away from politics. We wish to get away from the old world method of solving problems.